हमारे ऑफिसेस भी बंद हैं, उद्योग धंधे चल रहे हैं, निर्माण के कार्य चल रहे हैं, या जो उद्योग चल रहे हैं उनके लिए अनिवार्य शर्त है कि वे लोग अपने यहाँ कोविड हेल्प डेस्क बनाएंगे, वहाँ पे ट्रेंड स्टाफ होगा। नगरीय क्षेत्रों में या ग्रामीण क्षेत्र के भी मार्केट को दो दिन के लिए हम लोग वर्तमान में बंद कर रहे हैं।
कर्नाटका गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग अ मेजर पुश टू द हेल्थ केयर फैसिलिटीज एंड कोविड 19 मेडिकल स्ट्रक्चर इन बेंगलुरु एंड अदर डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स व्हिच आर अंडर लॉकडाउन सिंस जुलाई 14 फॉर अ वीक। The government is using this period to tie up the loose ends in the system to contain the spread of the virus. Massive revamping of the strategy is on ground during the lockdown and several steps taken to strengthen the facilities. The state government has decentralized the corona control room and divided Bengaluru in 8 zones with a control room each.
Making these zones, it has become easy to coordinate.
In decentralization is concerned,
yeah.
In one zone, there are only joint commission, only joint commission. Yes. His entire responsibility goes on that joint commissioner.
Meanwhile, in Kerala, the state government has confirmed cluster formation in coastal areas of Thiruvananthapuram that comes under a containment zone. The state government has decided to put a stop on all activities in such areas by taking tough steps. In view of the seriousness of the situation in Thiruvananthapuram, a complete lockdown has been announced from 18th July midnight to 28th July midnight.
Thiruvananthapuram already 12 clusters are formed and we are watching thoroughly what is happening in this cluster, and we are trying to contain this disease inside the cluster. We close that cluster and declare this a containment zone, and we are taking stringent activities in that clusters. And we are starting more CFLTCs, first line COVID first line treatment centers. And this is a first line treatment center. We have already more than 300 beds here, and we can set another 300 beds also here.
In Assam, the state government has decided to give exemptions in Guwahati from Monday onwards.
We have declared some relaxations looking into the economic activities, requirement of economic activities, and accordingly, we have allowed all the shops and business establishments on from Monday to Friday. That will be one side of the road alternatively. Wholesalers of essential items, wholesalers of non-essential items, vegetables, fish market wholesalers, etc. are allowed Monday to Friday, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Home delivery for vegetables, meat, fish allowed.
The Uttarakhand government has enforced a week-long lockdown to contain the spread of COVID-19 pandemic in the state. Chief Minister held a meeting with officers on Saturday.
पिछले हफ्ते हमने उसकी वजह से वहाँ पर लॉकडाउन भी किया था और उसके बहुत अच्छे परिणाम आए हैं और ये भी देखने में आया कि तीन लोग ऐसे थे जो सुपर स्प्रेडर जिनको कहा जा सकता है उससे कैसे उन लोगों ने बचाव किया और जो ट्रेसिंग की है वो बहुत अच्छी प्रशंसनीय कार्य वहाँ के प्रशासन ने किया है और एक एक को वो ट्रेस कर पाए।
While a team from the Union Health Ministry will be visiting Bihar on Sunday to take stock of the COVID-19 situation, Union Health Ministry and the center is continuously monitoring the situation in Bihar. Discussion is going on testing, infection areas and hotspots in Bihar. With Bureau Inputs, Newsnight Desk, DD India.
रक्षा मंत्री राजनाथ सिंह होल्ड सिक्योरिटी रिव्यू मीटिंग इन श्रीनगर विद चीफ ऑफ डिफेंस स्टाफ आर्मी चीफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर एंड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर डीजीपी रक्षा मंत्री टू विजिट अमरनाथ केव श्राइन टुडे. Three terrorists killed in an early morning encounter with security forces in South Kashmir's Shopian district. Search operation underway. Joint Admission Board of IITs decides to relax eligibility criteria for JEE Advanced 2020. All qualified candidates who have passed class 12th examinations will now be eligible for admissions in IITs this year, irrespective of marks obtained. Flood and landslide situation remains grim in Assam, claiming over 100 lives. Heavy rains continue to lash Mumbai and coastal Maharashtra. Several low-lying areas waterlogged due to incessant rainfall. And COVID recovery rate rises to over 63% with over 6.35 lakh recoveries. Active cases stand at 3.4 lakh with over 25,000 fatalities.